Hi, so today I thought I would do a quick video about mobile money in Rwanda. What it is, how you get it, and what you can use it for. Now what I'm going to talk about is specific to Rwanda, but mobile money works pretty much the same across the whole of East Africa as far as I know. But if you're living in another East African country and I say something that is completely different where you live, please do drop a comment because I'm sure it will be useful to somebody. So I moved back to Rwanda in 2014, and that was the very first time I had ever heard of mobile money. Because when you're buying things online in the UK, 90% of the time you're using PayPal for online secure transactions. But here in Rwanda, and in many countries, PayPal actually doesn't work. You can use it as an external device to load money onto it, and to receive virtual money, which you then go and find a vendor to withdraw from. But I think it's actually very difficult to link it to an actual bank account so that you can receive transactions directly into your bank account and make transactions that way. So more commonly, you will find people making transactions between individuals and between businesses using their mobile phones and using mobile money, which is abbreviated to MoMo. So here in Rwanda, we have two main phone companies. We've got Airtel and we've got MTN. So when you first arrive, the question is, well, which one do I go with? Now, MTN has a bit of a bad reputation. It is kind of jokingly known as the missing telephone network. It has been fined numerous times by the government for poor service. But at the same time, it is the largest network in the country. And even people who've got an Airtel SIM usually also have an MTN SIM. So there isn't much choice, but I would personally suggest going with MTN just because you're pretty much guaranteed that everybody you know will be using it. And if you're going to be using mobile money, pretty much everybody you know has an MTN MoMo account. So when you first arrive, you're going to head over to an MTN centre. You're going to take your passport, your ID, because you need that to get a SIM card. A SIM card costs, last time I bought one, which was a couple of years ago, it was about 500 francs, which is about 50 cents. So it's not going to be very much. It's unlikely to be over a dollar. So you get your SIM card, and once that's installed on your phone and you've topped up on it, you can also ask the vendor to set you up for mobile money and give you a mobile money account. Now your mobile money account is linked to your mobile number. So basically, it's the same as with PayPal. You know, if you're sending somebody money via PayPal, you just need their email address. So if somebody's sending you money via MoMo, they just need your phone number. So your phone number is the account number for you to receive mobile cash. Now, as far as I'm aware, you can go to an MTN center, hand over cash, and they will top that up onto your mobile money account. I've never actually done that. The way that I use mobile money is, most of the time, is I'm taking money from my UK account onto my Rwanda mobile money account so that I can pay vendors here, restaurants, individuals, using my mobile money account in Rwanda. And the way that I usually do that is taking money from my personal account in the UK using World Remit. So World Remit is just like Western Union. It's got some great functions. You can send cash for pickup in another country, but you can also send money directly to somebody's mobile money account, their MoMo account. So all I do is log into my account in the UK and I send myself money to my MTN mobile money account. And it's really simple. It just asks you how you want to send the money, for cash pickup or mobile money transfer. So you select the mobile money transfer. It asks you which network, so you want your MTN MoMo account. It asks you how much you want to send, and then it just asks you for the phone number. And away you go. It's super simple. You can just follow it step by step and it will guide you through. Now, the other service that I tend to use is called Hectorpay. And Hectorpay is more of a sort of a local service, but it's excellent. It allows you to pay using a debit or credit card and send money directly from that to your mobile money account. So I use this to take money from my business account in Rwanda and put that onto my mobile money account. Because for some reason, I mean, there are issues with banking, and one of them is with my particular bank. Is I can't connect my mobile money to my business account, so I can't pay for anything using my business account through MoMo. I don't know why. So the way around that is to use my business card and use it with HectorPay to transfer money from my Rwandan business account onto my mobile money account. I'll put the link to both of those below. World Remit, HectorPay, they're both so simple to use, very user-friendly, and solve a whole load of problems for me. So then, how do you use mobile money? Once you've got it, how do you make a payment? Well, I'm going to talk you through it. It is a little bit complicated, and I really am not a fan of mobile money. I find that it requires memorizing quite a few codes or writing those codes down, and there's also quite a broad possibility for a mistake. So, you know, I've had friends who we've been out for meals and afterwards have tried to pay the bill and accidentally sent the money to a complete stranger, which is a possibility with mobile money, and you've got to be really vigilant about it. So I think, you know, it is convenient in as much as you've got money on your mobile phone and you can pay businesses and pay shopping, pay delivery, whatever. But you do have to be really careful when you use it and just make absolutely sure before you hit the OK button that all of the details are absolutely correct. So the first thing to know about mobile money is that it relies on a lot of codes. So codes always begin with a star and they end with a hash. And you type these in on your phone screen and then you put the code between the star and the hash. So sometimes there is more than one part to the code, at which point you separate each part with a star. So asterisk, first part of the code, second part of the code, third part of the code, and then you always end with a hash. And hash, when you hit the call button, tells the phone or the provider that the code is complete. So the first code that's worth knowing is star 182 hash, and that will take you straight through to the mobile money application on your phone. So once you enter that and hit call, you'll get the full pop-up screen with the menu for mobile money, and this allows you to send money to somebody, it allows you to buy electricity, to pay RRA revenue bills, and a few other options in there. Now, if you're using mobile money for the first time, you might find that the menu comes up in Kinyarwanda. So if you're an English speaker, you need to type in the code star 182, star 6, star 5, star 1 hash. And if you send that, you'll be asked to enter your PIN code. So when you set up mobile money, you'll have a 5-digit PIN code that you choose. And you'll be asked to enter this whenever you're verifying a code or a payment. So type in that code, hit call, enter your PIN when prompted, and it should change the menu into English. So sending money to an individual using this system is pretty simple. It's star 182 hash to bring up the mobile money menu, and then from there all that you're going to do is select the first option, send money. From there you'll select the first option again, MoMo user, assuming that the person that you're sending money to also has a MoMo account, which pretty much everybody does. Next you'll be asked to enter the recipient's phone number. Then you'll be asked to enter the amount that you want to send. And at the end of that prompt, it will give you the name of the recipient that the number belongs to. So just check that and make sure that the name of the person you're sending the money to is the person that you expected to be sending the money to. If you're in any doubt at all, cancel the process, contact the person you're sending the money to, and just check that the name of the MoMo account definitely belongs to them. And finally, you'll be asked to enter your PIN number to confirm the payment. Once you've done all of that, you'll receive an SMS message once the money leaves your account and goes to their account, so you've got proof that you've made the payment. Okay, so sending to an individual is pretty straightforward. So is sending to a business, but there's sometimes a bit of a difference. So in Rwanda, to keep track of taxes, most businesses have their own dedicated six-digit MoMo code. So let's say that we went to Rose's restaurant, and at the end of the meal, you are given the MoMo code 102030. Now, the first time that somebody gives you a six-digit MoMo code, you might not quite know what to do with it. It isn't really that obvious a lot of the time. So the process goes like this. Instead of calling up the mobile money application on our phone, we're going to dial it in using the keypad. So any MTN MoMo application begins with *182. Then for this, we're going to go *8*1. And this is how we begin any business MoMo transaction when we're using a dedicated six-digit MoMo payment code. So after the one, we need another star. Then we're going to enter the business's digits. So here it needs to be 102030. Then we're going to put another star, and then we're going to put how much we're sending. So let's say that I spent 20,000 francs. So I'm going to put in 20,000, no comma. Don't put a comma in there. It's just the numbers. So again, if you're coming from the UK, the US, just be very careful about how many zeros you add to the payment. And then we're going to end it with a hash. Now, when we send that, we're going to get a pop-up, which is going to display the account name that we're sending this to. So it should say Rose's Restaurant, or it should have the same name as you see on the bill for the restaurant. So you know that you've definitely put in the correct MoMo code. If you've got any doubt, back out, cancel the application, and ask your waiter to confirm that it is the correct name on the MoMo account. It will also confirm the amount of money that you're sending, and if everything looks correct, if you've definitely got the name of the correct recipient and the amount that you entered is definitely correct, then you can go ahead and enter your PIN number and make that payment. Okay, so that's the basics of MoMo here in Rwanda. What it is, how you get it, how you put money on it, how you spend money on it. But I'm just warning you to be quite careful. This is something I really do worry about a lot with mobile money is, first of all, you've got to remember all the codes. And secondly, especially if you're coming from a country where there aren't that many zeros on the end of payments, is you need to make sure that you haven't put too many zeros on the money that you're sending. And you need to be sure that the recipient is definitely the right name for the phone number that you've typed in. And some businesses, the name on the account that you're sending it to is not the same as the restaurant that you're eating in. So for example, I eat a lot at a restaurant called The Hut, but when I send by mobile money, their company registration name is Thompson and Company or something. So they don't quite match up, so I need to be certain that I know that the MoMo account belongs to the business that I'm paying. So a couple of other things just to be really careful of, especially if you're out with friends, you're having a drink, and you're paying by mobile money, just really sober up for that split second and pay attention to what you're typing. It happens so often. Like, I had a friend who we'd just been at a restaurant and she accidentally sent 100,000 francs or $100 to a complete stranger because she put in a couple of digits in the mobile money phone number incorrectly, but we were out, she was distracted, and she didn't notice that she'd done that until we were going to leave. And the waiter, of course, said, well, the payment hasn't gone through. And then she realized it had gone to somebody else. And the other one to watch out for is a little con that I've seen going on with motos late at night, again, going home, maybe not fully aware of what's going on. And you're trying to pay a moto, and the moto driver gives you the mobile money number, which you type in. And you confirm names. So say his name's John, you type in his phone number, it says, do you want to send money to John whoever? And you say, oh, are you John? And they say, yes, I'm John. So you hit enter and through the money goes. And you wait, and you wait, And you wait, and the money doesn't appear on his phone. And what he's actually done is given you the phone number for his friend who has the same name. So, you know, he's confirmed he's John. The person you sent it to is John. You think it's this John, but it's a different John. And of course, it's late at night, especially if you're a woman hanging around in a dark street. You don't want to, you know, get into an argument. You just want to go home. And so you pay him again. And this time, you know, he'll type in his number and you'll stand there and make sure that the money arrives on his phone. So he gets paid and his friend gets paid. So, you know, just be careful of that one. Generally speaking, my advice to everybody is don't use mobile money if you're going out for the night, just unless you're going to remain completely teetotal and very aware of what you're doing. It's a terrible system for like that kind of thing, because the ability to make a mistake with one digit is vast. So yeah, I mean, everybody loves mobile money because it's convenient for like paying friends and family. If there's an emergency, you've got a friend who needs phone credit, you've got, you know, somebody who needs bus fare from Giseni. Very, very good for that. But in kind of a wider context, I just find it very clunky. You know, it kind of feels like ASCII art compared to sort of a digital photo, if that makes sense. But anyway, that's how you use it. So let me know how you use your mobile money, what you use it for most, any other cons that you've seen going on that people should be aware of. Any questions about it, drop below. If I can, I will answer them. And if I can't, I will try to find somebody who can. And yeah, all hail mobile money.
So just something insane that happened, but HepTapay saw this video and they contacted me to ask if they could use it on their website. And so I love the product, so I said yes, do whatever you like with it. And next thing I know, I am face of HepTapay. So yeah.